So starting with the footwork, the way I do it is based on the old French-Canadian way. With my right foot, I'm making quarter note beats with my heel and my toe. And with my left foot, I'm doing the in-between beat, also known as the up beat. Same rhythm that you're using on the banjo. 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4. A little slower. So what I do is I mix and match three different things. I sometimes just do this. Sometimes I do this. Sometimes I do both. So I'm doing the toe every upbeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and like that. Sometimes I'm using the heel instead. The heels and toes have different pitches. The pitch of the toe is high, and the heel is lower. So it's fun to play around with that. Hear subtle differences in pitch. And then I kind of mix and match all that stuff to make a rhythm that's playful with the rhythm of whatever tune I'm doing, like. You get the idea? And then I'll play Shady Grove, and I'm going to play it in B.
Okay.
Okay. I've got this tuned up. I've got a capoed 4. I'm in the G modal tuning, but capoed 4, so I'm in B minor, which is kind of an unfriendly key for jam sessions. So sometimes I'll play it in A minor in a jam session. And I'll play it slowly. I'll play Shady Grove 1, which is the simple one, and I'll play it basically like the tab, but I'm not looking at the tab, so I might do a couple little different things. Is that a good speed, or is it too fast? Well, the last time I saw Shady Grove, she was standing in the door, shoes and stockings in her hands, and little bare feet on the floor. Shady Grove, my little love, Shady Grove, I know. Shady Grove, my little love, I'm bound for the Shady Grove. And the other Shady Grove 2, is a full-blown dance tune version of Shady Grove, where you do the A part and repeat that, and then there's a B part. So that goes like this. Thank you.
And then if you put it all together with the feet, and then how does that...
From our performance. I take all those lyrics and I weave it into the more complicated version. And I take A's and B's and I sing them and play them. And then I do instrumentals where I just either do the A part or the B part in between or more than one time. Something to that effect, you can make it longer. That for me is an improvised piece. I mix and match the verses and do them in different orders.